والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، Dear brothers and children and respected sisters, I advise you and myself with the advice that Allah gave us in the Quran. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O ye who believe, fear Allah the way he should be feared and do not die except in the state of Islam. اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وكل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك. O Allah, we ask you to love you and to love those who love you and to love any act that will bring us closer to your love. The love of Allah The love of Allah is very touchy subject, because the love in general is the food of our hearts. The love is the something, our life without it means nothing. So imagine if we are talking about the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the hadith reported by Al-Bukhari and Muslim, that Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu anhuma qal, baynama ana wa rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kharijain min al-masjid. The hadith is reported that Anas ibn Malik, may Allah be pleased with both of them, he said, while the Prophet ﷺ and I live in the masjid, وَلَقِينَ رَجُلًا عِنْدَ سِدَّةِ الْمَسْجِدِ, we met a man at the front of the masjid. فَقَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَتَ السَّاعَةِ, the man asked the Prophet ﷺ, when is the hour, when is the day of judgment? The Prophet ﷺ replied, فَمَا أَعْدَدْتَ لَهَا, what have you prepared for it? You asking about the day of judgment, what have you prepared for it? The man replied, مَا أَعْدَدْتُ لَهَا مِنْ كَثِيرِ صَدَقَةٍ وَلَا صِيَامٍ وَلَا صَلَاةٍ وَلَكِنِّي أُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. The man replied, I have not prepared a lot of deeds like prayers, charity, fasting, but, and be careful here, listen, but I love Allah and him and his messenger. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, قال فأنت مع من أحببت. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, then you are with whom you loved. So this man, he prepared for the day of judgment a little work, but in his heart was full with the love of Allah and his messenger. That love took him to the level that he will be in the day of judgment with those whom he loved in his heart. That meaning he will be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and with Allah, which is a high level. Listen to this. Anas continue, as reported in Sahih Muslim, he said, فَمَا فَرِحْنَا بَعْدَ الْإِسْلَامِ فَرَحًا أَشَدَّ مِنْ قَوْلِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَأَنْتَ مَعَ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. We have never, this is what Anas the Sahabi, the companion said, we have never felt more compassionate or happiness after Islam more than we felt when we heard this statement from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that you are with whom you loved. It's a great statement, a great message. You will be with whom you loved. So if you are loving Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you will be with them. And Anas said, continue again in Sahih Muslim, فَإِنِّي أُحِبُّ اللَّهِ. He make it like a statement. I love Allah and I love His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I love Abu Bakr and I love Umar, and I hope I will be with them, although I did not do as much as they did. This is the hadith we will try to touch on tonight. So brothers, the love in the heart, as we said earlier, it is the life of the heart. It is the food of the heart. The heart without this love means nothing. And this is where we need to compete among ourselves to increase this love in our hearts to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are two levels of this love. The first level is that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second level is that Allah loves you, which is a higher level. Even if you look at the love in this dunya, and for Allah is the best example, which is better, to love or to be loved? Anything or any person we love in this dunya, if we compare, which is better for me as a human, is to love or to be loved? To be loved is a higher level. Because you can love any person, but that doesn't mean they love you. You can love the other person for years and years, but that doesn't mean the other person loves you. So it will be a great happiness for you when you know that the other person loves you. So you've been loved. And as we said, for Allah is the best example. Imagine this happens between you and Allah. You love Allah, which you can feel it in your heart, but you don't know if Allah loves you or not. Imagine you get the message that Allah loves you. This is a great blessing from Allah. So how we can reach this level? How we can get to the level of being loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Inshallah tonight, we'll go over 10 things that we can do that bring us to this level, to the level that being loved. The first action we can do is to read Al-Quran. Not only just reading, we need to reflect on the Quran. When you read the Quran, you need to think of it that this is the words of Allah. This is the dialogue between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not like any other book. This is the dialogue. Allah is talking to you. And if you go to the tafsir of Surah Al-Fatiha, the explanation, it's a dialogue, direct dialogue between you and Allah. You talking to Allah and Allah is responding to you in the surah. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin. Yaqul Allah, Allah will say, Hamadani Abdi, Majjadani Abdi. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Oh Allah, we seek refuge in you and we seek help in you. Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim. Show us the right path. Then Allah will say, I guided you. I gave you the right path. It's a dialogue, direct dialogue between you and Allah. So we need to reflect in the Quran. The scholar said, the Quran is like letters from Allah to you. You need to reflect on these letters. What's the message there? How can I live this message into my life? One of the companions used to read in his prayer very often Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. So some of the companions who praying behind him, they were complaining. You know, you always read in قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ is a short surah. You always read in قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ask him why. He said, because it has the attributes of Ar-Rahman. And I like to read the attributes of Ar-Rahman. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, tell him that Allah loves him. Imagine. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to spend the whole night in one ayah. The whole night praying in one ayah. Just keep reflecting on this ayah. The second thing we can do to reach the level of being loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is النوافل بعد الفرائض, to do the extra deeds but after the obligatory. I mean, the extra deeds, be careful, has to be after we fulfill our obligatory deeds. Adhan time, inshallah. Let's make for that. Do we have any one of our youth to make the adhan, inshallah? Yes, I see young people there. I need one of you to be here, inshallah. Yalla, come on. Yes. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. The second action we can do is to do the extra deeds after we fulfill our obligatory. To do the nafila above and beyond the fariḍa. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, Qudsi, Allah is saying, this is the hadith, من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Whoever make a hardship to one of my beloved, I will declare war against him. This is what Allah is saying. Allah will declare war against those who making hardship to his beloved people. وما تقرب عبدي إلي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضت عليه. And my servants, there is no dearer to me that will bring him closer to me better than the obligatory deeds. So the first we have to do the obligatory. ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه. And my servant keep coming closer to me and dearer to me with the extras until I love him. This is the message. Until I love him. Allah is saying. فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُمْ. Listen, Lord of Heaven. If Allah loves you. And should I love him? كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ. I will be his earring or his hearing that he hear with. وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصُرُ بِهِ. And his vision that he sees with. وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَطُّشُ بِهَا وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا. I will be his arm and his leg. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأَعْطِيَنَّهُ. Meaning Allah will become, as he said, when you get closer to Allah with the obligatory, then you increase your nawafil, the extra deeds, then Allah will love you. And if Allah loves you, all your jawarih, which means your limbs, will be acting upon what Allah loves. Your vision, your hearing, your arms, your legs, everything will act upon what Allah loves. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأَعْطِيَنَّهُ. Should he ask me, I will give him. وَلَئِنْ اسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأَعْوَذَنَّهُ. Should he seek refuge in me, I will give him refuge. This is hadith reported in al-Bukhari. This is the level when you become beloved or become in this level that Allah loves you. All your life will become according to what Allah loves. A third action we can do to get to that level is a dhikr. Always have your tongue wet. What does that mean? Your tongue should not stop. Always making dhikr. Subhanallah, subhanallah, astaghfirullah. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Always. When you go to the market, keep your tongue moving. Don't stop. You're trying to buy something, okay, subhanallah, look in the market, subhanallah, la ilaha illallah, astaghfirullah, la hawla wa la quwwata illa. When you're driving, when you are in the gym, playing on your treadmill or at home, running on the corniche, imagine how many steps you can run on the corniche. With every step you say, subhanallah, walhamdulillah. Keep your tongue moving with the dhikr of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And listen to this hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَنَا مَعْ عَبْدِي مَا ذَكَرَنِي وَتَحَرَّكَتْ بِي شَفَتَهُ. I am always with my servant as long as he remembers me and his lips say, making dhikr for me. So when you are making dhikr, Allah is with you. Imagine, Allah, the creator, is with you. That means you are protected. You don't worry about the whole world. You don't worry about anything. Allah is with you now. Make dhikr all the time. Allah will be with you. And Allah said in the Quran, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me, I will remember you. And the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that when the people in the day of judgment, they gather together, they will remember any gathering in this dunya that they did not mention Allah in it, they will be very sorry for it. Even if they are going to the Jannah, even if they get their books in their right hands and they know that they are going to the Jannah after the Day of Judgment, but they will be very sad for any gathering in their book that there is no mention of Allah in it. So inshallah we need to make it a habit in our daily life to teach our families, to teach our children, always to make dhikr. When you're driving with your kids in the car, you're going for a long trip, teach them to make dhikr, subhanallah. Let's say, who can count the names of Allah? Let your children memorize the names of Allah. Saying the names of Allah, the attributes of Allah, is a great thing. Try to teach them the dua by mentioning the names of Allah. There are very powerful duas, brother. Very powerful. If you mention a dua and that has a name of Allah in it, you don't know how much power in it. I heard, subhanAllah, some of our friends, you know how difficult it is to find parking here in town. I know some brothers, they make special dua when they go. And they told me it's working. I said, okay, let me try it. Because you know what? Allah is powerful. Allah can make anything. And I start trying it. It worked with me. Not only for the parking, because I found more important things in my life. I need to make dua for it. And I taught it to my children. And now my children, before they go to the exam, they make the dua. And one of my children told me, my dad, inside the exam room, I feel more comfort than what I feel inside the house because of this dua. Imagine, you are in the middle of the test. You're supposed to be nervous, shaken, scared. She told me, no, dad, I feel more comfort. I said, what's different? I said, I don't know, maybe because of this dua. The dua is, I'm just going to teach it for you because it's very powerful. اللهم إني أسألك بأني أشهدك أنك أنت الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الواحد الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. You put all the great names of Allah here. And we know that Allah has a great name. If you ask him with it, he will respond to you. I believe very strongly the great name of Allah is in this dua. Allahumma inni as'aluka bi anni yushhiduka annaka anta Allah alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-wahid al-ahad as-samad alladhi lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakun lahu kufuwan ahad. Then you ask Allah what you want. It's a great dua. So always keep your tongue wet mentioning Allah, la ilaha illallah. Another action, number 4. Now we get into more difficult actions. We started with the easy ones. Now this is for, you know, grade B. We started with any action that all of us can do. But now is the competition get more tough. So we need to see who can do this. Number 4 is always to put what Allah loves before what you love. Especially when we see, when it comes something that our self desire. Always compare, even in the halal thing, compare what you love and what Allah loves and do what Allah loves. For example, maybe if you want to go to sleep sometimes, tired, you want to go to sleep. There is nothing haram in going to sleep. It is halal thing. But you said, why to go to sleep? I mean, this hour I can go to sleep, I can pray 10 rak'ahs in this hour, or I can read juz of the Quran. Now yourself, the desire here is to go to sleep. But you put what Allah loves more or before what you love. This is a higher level to get closer to that. And to do that, to get to this level, or to you can be able to do this action, to prefer what Allah loves over what you love, we need to do 3 things. First, we need to humiliate ourselves, that self itself, because the self has desires. Oh yes, I want to go to sleep. Why to? It's Thursday night, I want to stay home, watch TV. Why to go to the embassy and to get in this gathering and get tired you know, I can be laying down watching TV. This is what the self wants. You know what? Tell the self, you know, I'm going to humiliate you. I'm not going to let you control me. I'm going to get up, go to the embassy, listen to the class, mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and get more reward. Second, we need to do the opposite of what our self desires. Because the self always desire, the desires we have is what we call the al-hawa, which means what the self wants to get. So do the opposite. The self wants to go to sleep? No, get up. Allah said in the Quran, الَّذِينَ تَتَجَافَ جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ. Those who stay away from the beds to remember Allah. And another thing we can do is to declare a war against the shaitan. Because the shaitan doesn't want you to do what Allah loves. He wants you to do what yourself desires. This is a very beautiful saying here by Ibn Taymiyyah. I want to share with you. He said that the self, when the self has a desire, you will not be punished on it. As long as it's still inside you, it's a desire to do something bad. You will not be punished for doing it. As long as still within the self. But if you don't do it because you love Allah and you know that Allah does not love this action, then you will get reward for it. As simple as that. You did not do anything. There is no action you have done here. But you get reward for not doing something. Imagine how beautiful is this. This is extra reward. Yourself comes to you, said, oh, this is something I want to do. It's a bad action. Then you talk to back to yourself, say, you know what, myself, I'm not going to do it because Allah does not love this. I want to please Allah. Then you get reward for doing nothing. So this is how we bring the love of Allah over our love and what we like. Number five is to reflect in the names and the attributes of Allah. As we mentioned earlier, that when you make dua, like the dua we mentioned, has the names of Allah, reflect in the names of Allah. That will bring you closer to Allah. When you think of Allah, Allah is the Razzaq, the provider. What does that mean? Reflect into that. Allah is the provider. That means it's not my company, it's not my boss, it's not whatever. It is Allah who gave me the wealth. So I should not make my job prevent me from doing my deeds. Allah is the generous. What does that mean? That means Allah gave me without asking Him. Subhanallah, in this dunya, if the person in need, he will go and ask the other people to give him. But look at Allah. Allah gives before the people ask Him. We just get born and Allah give us food, give us drink, give us health, give us a lot of things before even we did not ask for it. Because Allah is very generous. Allah gives before we ask for it. So what does that mean? That means I need to take this attribute and apply it to myself as a believer. I need to give the others. I need to feel with the poor and with the needy. And don't wait until they come and ask you. You go and ask on them. It was mentioned in one of the stories that a righteous man, he was very generous. One day a poor came to his house, knock on the door, and he asked him. So he went inside, brought the big things, food, whatever, and he came back to him and he gave it to him, and he closed the door, went back to his family crying. His wife asked him, why are you crying? just gave him. He get reward. He said, I'm crying because I made him come to ask me. I waited until he came and asked to get help from me. I should go and give him help before he comes and asks for me. So we need to reflect on the names of Allah. The more we reflect on the names of Allah, the more we love Allah. And again, for Allah is the best example. Let's apply it even on the love of the dunya. When a person loves another person, especially for somebody who's got engaged, his fiancé, he loves his fiancé before they get into marriage and start not loving each other. But so you get the love of the dunya, he always mention her name and how beautiful she is and how, you know, all the good attributes of her. And the more he think of it, the more her love in his heart will increase. This is on the dunya thing. And for Allah is the best example. Imagine if you reflect that on Allah. You think of Allah, of his names, his attributes. That love in your heart increase day on day. We need to work on it. It's not something that we go to bed and we wake up, we love Allah. It is something, an action we need to do daily to increase this love. Number six is to reflect on the blessings of Allah. As we mentioned earlier, Allah provide us before we ask. Imagine if somebody in the dunya, and again for Allah is the best example, you know, came to you and said, you know what, you need a car, here you go, take a car, take these keys, this car for you. Then you will love this person. So reflect on what Allah gave you. The health, alhamdulillah, I have my two arms, my two legs. I'm walking, I'm speaking, I can see, I can hear, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. This is a great blessing from Allah. I can go to bed to sleep, some people they cannot sleep. I can find food to eat. Some people, they can find the food, but they cannot eat it. They are sick. Or some people, they cannot find the food to start with. So reflect on the blessings of Allah to increase His love in your heart. Number seven is to break your heart or humble your heart when you think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know one of the greatest sins that Iblis commits himself is the kibr, the arrogance. Iblis has arrogance. How come I, he asks Allah, how do you want me to prostrate to this creation you made? This is arrogance. His heart has arrogance. He did not humble his heart for his Lord. So we need to humble our heart for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, Allah, we are weak. We cannot make it without you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot live our daily life without you, subhanallah. So we need to reflect and humble our hearts into that. Number eight, which is a very great thing, and it has all what we mentioned above, you can do it in this action only, which is, before I'm going to mention what is, I'm going to ask you, brothers. When you love a person, what the thing you wish the most? To answer that, to help you. The thing I wish the most for that person is to be with him. When I love a person, the thing I wish the most is to be with him. If you are here and your family in Sri Lanka, or in Egypt, or in Europe, you feel sorry, you feel sad in your heart. You love to be with them because you love them. So this is a great thing in the love, is to be with whom you love. So how can we be with Allah in this life? Can we? Yes, you can. Every day you can be with Allah alone. if you want. In the third part of the night, Allah comes down. Allah descend down to the first heaven. He said that. And He will be with you when you wake up in the third part of the night. Wake up to pray alone. Then you will be alone with your Lord. You will be alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will be alone with whom you loved. This is, and with this, you can do all what we mentioned before. You remember Allah. You mention Allah. You read the Quran. You reflect on the blessings of Allah. You make your tongue wet by remembering Allah. You mention Allah. All this could happen in this action only. Wake up at the third part of the night and remember Allah. Somebody was asking me, I was talking to somebody, and he told me that his Quran teacher, the one who teach him Quran, has a light on his face. He feels some brightness in his face. And subhanAllah, when I was reading this hadith, I told him, I can answer you why. Listen to this. By Al-Hasan Al-Basri. Al-Hasan Al-Basri, he's one of the second generation after the Sahaba, the followers, and he was raised by Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu. He said, لم أجد من العبادة شيئا أشد من الصلاة في جوف الليل. He said, I did not see better in any worshipping than praying at the middle of the night. Then he was asked, why the people who pray at night, they have their faces with brightness? He said, because لأنهم خلوا بالرحمن فألبسهم من نوره. Because they were alone with Allah, so He showered them with His light. Being alone with Allah at the middle of the night, He will shower you with His light. What a great brightness you can have in your heart, in your face, and in your heart. Number nine is to live to these gatherings, to sit with those who love Allah. And in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wajabat mahabbati lil mutahabbin fi, that my love is a mandatory or a must for those who love each other because of me. And my love becomes a must or granted for those who gather together because of me. And my love will be granted for those who visited each other because of me. So increase your interaction with your brothers because you love Allah and you want to be with them. The last one we will say here, inshallah, the last action we can do is try to remove from your heart anything that push you away from the love of Allah. Anything in the heart. Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran that if you love your parents, your children, your wives, your families, your business, your houses more than Allah and His Messenger, then wait until Allah send His punishment on you. So yes, we love those people. All those things are halal. But they are not more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The love of Allah is the utmost. Everything else comes after that. So if you find anything in your heart that brings you away from this love, remove it. So that will help you to go back and get closer to Allah. So these, my dear brothers, these are some of the actions we can do. I share them with you tonight. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and to allow us to do these things and to love Him and to love everyone who loves Him, because loving the people who love Allah bring us closer to Allah. O Allah, Allahumma nas'aluka an nuhibbuka wa nuhibba man yuhibbuka wa nuhibba man yuqarribuna ila hubbika ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma nas'aluka hubba Rasulika sallallahu alayhi wa sallam
وحب أصحابه صل عليهم أفضل الصلاة والتسليم ورضوان. أنا أحب أصحابك.